clip doesn't really show anything fancy. It just shows that a really skilled, dynamic player like Alice Oriel can also take a lot of pride in the other parts of the game, in this case, the penalty kill. And we're just going to track her shift a little bit here to demonstrate how committed all players can be in all facets of the game. So she wins a draw there exactly as drawn up, a little bump to the weak side. We don't get the exit that we want from the play. And so now Alice has to play the system and be in the right position to kill the penalty. Just really simply, you see her stick on the ice, in the middle of the ice where she's supposed to be. Now she's in the shooting lane, forcing the penalty kill to adjust. Really good rotation here, just her understanding of the system, knowing that we like to pressure these pucks below the goal line with that net front defenseman. So as the net front defenseman goes down to the goal line, Alice rotates down to the net front, and you can see her right here. And she's ready for a three-point press if that puck went over to the other side of the goal line. Again, you see really good rotation down in the net front because we're pressing with 2D in the corner, trying to get this puck out. And Alice knows that if we get this puck out, we're looking for a dot lane exit or a weak side exit. We don't end up winning the battle. So back into position again. She's forcing that puck away from the middle. They do a really good job of passing it through the seam here and generating a scoring chance. Our defenseman, Elodie, gets out for the block shot there. Really good play by them again to keep the play alive. Again, you just see the quick rotation of Alice getting out to the point, to pressure, leading with the stick. Really good defensive technique here. Doesn't quite get it. And then right back to her spot, her and Svenja. Really good communication there. That's the part of the clip that I love. First off, starts with Alice understanding where she needs to be at the right time. We lose another battle in the corner here, but she's in really good position to get a good stick and block that shot. So just a really good, this is another really good clip of Alice. Again, remember, she's one of our more skilled and dynamic players, big part of our offense, and we got her out here on a 4-on-5 situation to kill a penalty in an important game for us. And just her buy-in, her coachability, playing the system, being at the right place at the right time, and willing to sacrifice her body to make a play. So right here, we just fall into our 1-3, the penalty killer, decides to flush the D out, first pass. And there you see Alice right in the right place to angle off the next pass. And her job is to contest this puck carrier, force that puck carrier to make a play with the puck. That's exactly play. So just a really good example of the player buying in and playing the system. This is a great clip. Again, penalty kill clip focusing on Alice Soriel. When you can get your skilled, fast, smart offensive players buying into the other side of the game, playing off the puck, playing hard, competing defensively, and in this case, in a shorthanded situation, it just makes your team so much better. So in this case, you're going to see Alice off a lost draw. Just use her speed and pressure to get out and apply pressure and force the C to make a hurried play which leads to a good clear, even though we lose the draw. So there she goes, using her speed and agility to force a hurried pass, and then reliably clears the puck past the blue line for a little chip and chase one-on-one situation with a really good player in Emma Kreis. So this is one of my favorite clips. A clip we often show the girls is Poulin taking a shot, a block shot in the throat during the World Championships, and then followed by later in the tournament scoring the winning goal in overtime to seal the deal for Canada in the championship final against the Americans. And we show that clip as a reminder and as an aspirational way to play the game. And again, Alice Soriel, in this case, you see the circle around her. She's one of her leading scorers. She's out for every power play. She generates a ton of offense in the offensive zone. But this is the layer that she's added to her game, and St. Cloud State is getting just an unbelievable player here. It's, again, like I said, one of my favorite clips of the year. So out there and into a block shot with an easy clear. I just love that stuff. It's amazing. So here we have Alice on the power play, and you'll notice one of the things that she does extremely well is draws attention and creates space for other players. She's probably the best on our team at doing it, and we'll roll a couple clips here to show you. So right away, she's presented herself as a threat, and you see the penalty killers all pointing toe caps towards her. She understands this better than anyone, and what she's really trying to do is create space up top here for this player to have a good shot. You'll notice that we've got two big players at the net front as well, creating traffic for the goalies. And there it is, shot up top, good traffic, a little high and wide, with a good recovery on the other side of the flank, and a reset. Now you got Alice down to the back post. She also does a really good job of identifying the open lane on the power play. Almost comes to her. Right away again, she recognizes that where the open ice is, she knows that the open ice is in this area here, and she'll reset it. She likes to draw the power play up to her. Not so good in that case. She tried to go to the net front. But right there, there's a really good example of what I'm talking about. So she's taking this puck into the area to draw and squeeze the penalty kill towards her before resetting it or giving it back up top. Right there. And up top with all that room. In that case, we'd like to see the defender, in this case, Gracie, a little lower, get a little closer to the net for a shot. Again, this is something that our power play understands really well, that when the puck and the penalty kill is on one side, when at least three penalty killers are on one side, we want this puck getting over to the weak side as soon as possible. Gracie understands this. Now Alice has got time and room to work, and she's going to draw the penalty kill towards her, knowing that she's going to create ice back up top here for Gracie. Her first look is a cross seam. She's looking for Emma there. And then she goes to work here. Lots of times you'll see her do an around the back pass. And, you know, there's the subtle subtle skill of using hands around the body to make this play. And there it is with that pass, hands around the body for another good shot from the point. So in a previous clip, we talked about Alice working the flank on the power play and creating space from low to high. Here she creates space from high to low, allowing her teammate Emma Christ to walk the goal line and generate a chance. So we'll just watch. So obviously the threat and deception of passing across to this defenseman, almost acting as a decoy in this case, creates this time and space for Alice to get the puck down low and for a goal line walk, maybe attacking from the back door. So she turns that defender's feet completely around because she has to honor her. And as soon as Alice sees that defender's feet completely turned around, in this case, completely, her back is completely to the puck threat. It really generates time and space for this player to go to work here. And we got a player uncontested at the net front as well. Would have been nice in this case to see this player seal off that penalty killer and give her a stick to the back door, something we can work on down the road. Well, she kind of does anyways. Sure. So at first glance, that may seem like a selfish play, but what she's trying to do here, we talk about goalies going down into this RVH position, and she's trying to pick her up top on the short side, catching the goalie going down on one knee like so many goalies do. So really not a selfish play, a pretty smart offensive play, all created by Alice drawing attention to her. This clip on the power play, focusing on Alice Soriel, shows her ability to keep the opposition defense, in this case, off balance with her deception. She's absolutely brilliant in her deception. You see it so much in practice, especially when we play down low competitive games and scenarios. And she really keeps the defender off balance with this deception. It's kind of Patrick Kane-like. You see Patrick Kane do a lot of this in the NHL. Just little looks over her shoulder, little weight and unweight. Always, being a threat to pass or being a threat to go a different direction. Like I said, keeping the defender off balance. So right here, again, a player like Alice has the penalty kill exactly where she wants them. All four penalty killers have their toe caps pointed at her, and now she'll go to work. It's so subtle, you really have to look for it. I'm going to just rewind that and play it in real time. You might have to play it two or three times, but when you look at the effect that it has on the penalty kill, how she draws everybody towards her, runs a little high exchange with the defender, and now we've created all this space for the real threat in the middle of the ice, again, with net front presence and allowing two good players to go to work and create a great play from the best area on the ice. Good save by the goalie and on the rebound as well. So all set up with a little deception on the half wall QB or the flank QB, in this case Alice. And then again, she really understands the value and the importance of just resetting and displaying patience on the power play. So she gets it back in the hands of the quarterback and gets back into position to reset.